First up, a look at the Asian markets. Well, the US markets weren't a problem, barring Boeing shares. The Dow, remember, ended about 96 points lower. However, Boeing dragged that index by about 150 points. So, ex of that, the Dow would have been in the positive to the tune of around 40, 50 points. However, more importantly, if you just take a look at what took place in the European markets post-market, we got the deal coming in from Brexit, which was actually a no deal. There were global uncertainties after UK's lawmaker for the second time rejected the terms of a deal coming in for Britain to withdraw from the European region. And that's exactly what is causing the pressure on the Asian markets. So the Japanese index opened mildly in the green. From there, it has dipped into the red at the low point of the day, about 0.75% lower. And all the other Asian indices are also at the low point of the day or off the early high. So we have the Korean index too, trading with cuts of about 0.8%. The Straits as well as the Taiwanese indices, both of them off the highs, the Straits sitting closer to the lower end of today's trading range. More importantly, what this means for the SGX Nifty is while it is showing a mild red tick, it is outperforming the other Asian peers. We're sitting on a strong rally of close to around 509 points in just the last 7 trading sessions. Let's see whether this minor dip that there is will be used as an opportunity for the bulls to go ahead and bite more of the Indian apple. More importantly, let's see where the SGX Nifty goes as well, given the sort of uncertainty that there is with regards to the Brexit. Currently indicating a flat to mild negative start, but in light with where the Asian markets are performing, it is a strong outperformance.